Hi everyone, welcome to this video on how to get started with the Blazer circular gauge of Synfusion. In general, the circular gauges are used for visualizing the numeric measurements in a circular scale. It usually has one or more pointers to indicate a specific value on the scale. Look at this online example. Here, you can see the Blazer circular gauge displayed with different elements like pointer, labels, and ticks. Now, I'm going to show you how to add such Blazer circular gauge of Synfusion to a Blazer server app using Visual Studio 2019 with these elements. So, let me start with the Blazer application creation process. For that, I need to make sure whether .NET Core SDK 3.1.2 or later versions are installed in my machine, and I should have Visual Studio Code or Visual Studio 2019 to create a Blazer application. In this tutorial, I'm going to create a new server-side Blazer app. So, let me open the Visual Studio 2019 first and create a new project from the dashboard. From the list of project templates, I will choose Blazer app and click next to proceed further with the project creation. Here, I will name my project as Blazer example and click the create button. Next, I will choose this Blazer server app option and click this create button finally to complete the project creation. Now, the project has been created and ready to use. If you want to know more about the Blazer server app and how to add Synfusion components to it, then you can listen to the video link that is shown in the above YouTube card. Now, I will tell you the steps to add Blazer circular gauge. To start using the Synfusion Blazer circular gauge, first, I need to install the Synfusion NuGet package into my application. For that, I will open the NuGet package manager by right-clicking the project and choose the option Manage NuGet Packages. Then, I will search for Synfusion Blazer in the Browse tab and install it into my project. Once the installation gets completed, let me navigate to imports.razor file, and here, I will add Synfusion Blazer circular gauge namespace to start using the Blazer circular gauge in any of the components available under the Pages folder. Next, I will open the startup.cs file, and here I will add Synfusion Blazer namespace. Then I will register the Synfusion Blazer service by calling a method addSynfusionBlazer within the configure services method. Also, I should register valid license key into my application. So, let me register the trial license key using the register license method. Now, everything is configured. So, let me start to add the Blazer circular gauge. For that, I need to open the index.razor component, and here I will include the tag SF circular gauge by replacing the default code. Now, I'm going to run this example. So here, you can see the circular gauge rendered with default elements like pointer, labels, and ticks. Here, you can see the start and end angle of the axis starting at 200 and ending at 160 degree as the circle is drawn from top like this. Also, you can customize these axis angles by setting custom values to it using the start angle and end angle properties. To set custom angles, I need to define circular gauge axis tag, which is of type array and can contain n number of circular gauge axis definitions inside it. As gauge holds single axis, so I will define a single circular gauge axis tag within the circular gauge axis tag. Now, I'm going to define the properties start angle and end angle with the value 270 and 90 degree respectively. When you look at the circular gauge now, the axis is starting at 270 degree and ending at 90 degree. By default, the radius of the axis will be based on the available screen size. In case, if I would like to set custom radius for the axis, then I need to use radius property of circular gauge. To set different radius value for the axis, I will define the property radius and set its value as 200 within the circular gauge axis tag. Here, I have set the radius value in pixel. So now, you can see the Blazor circular gauge rendered with 200 pixel radius axis. Here, default pointer value is 0. In case, if I would like to display the pointer value at 40, then I may need to set the value property to circular gauge. To set new value to this pointer, I need to define the circular gauge pointers tag, which is of type array and can contain n number of circular gauge pointer definitions inside it. Currently, the gauge holds a single pointer element, so I will define a single circular gauge pointer tag with the property value inside the circular gauge pointers tag. For this value property, I will set its value as 40, as I'm going to show the pointer value at 40 in the circular scale. Along with this, I have also planned to set custom radius for circular gauge pointer cap. So, let me define circular gauge cap tag and set its radius as 15. See the output now. The circular gauge displays the pointer value at 40. Now, I'm going to show you how to set ranges for the axis. To set ranges for axis, first I need to define circular gauge ranges tag, which is of type array and can contain n number of circular gauge range tag definitions inside it. Now, I have planned to add a single range, so let me define a single circular gauge range tag within the circular gauge ranges tag. Then, I will define start and end properties with the value 40 and 80 respectively. Look at the circular gauge now. The range is added between the values 40 and 80 on the circular scale. By default, you can notice that the labels are placed inside the axis with the offset value 5. In case, if I would like to display the labels outside the axis, then I need to make use of the position property. To change the label position, first I need to define circular gauge axis label style tag and set its position as outside. So here, you can see the circular gauge, the labels are placed outside the axis. Now, let me make a quick recap of what we have seen so far. We have seen how to create a Blazor project using Visual Studio 2019 and added a Synfusion Blazor circular gauge component in the server app. Also, we have seen how to change the axis pointer value, start angle and end angle, as well as the axis radius. Finally, we have also seen how to modify the label position and start and end range of an axis. If you would like to see the working of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link, which is shared in the description part below. You can also grab your chance of getting free license key to use a complete Blazor products if you fit into a community guidelines. So, check the link given in the description part to know if you are eligible for using a community license. Also, if you find this video as useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching this video.